I know it's only May of 2023 and we have to get to November of 2024 before we have our next big nationwide election. But if the poll numbers that are out right now and, you know, the polling trends that have been going on for many, many months now, all the way before the 2022 midterms, if those are any indication, then Republicans are about to have the worst election cycle that they've had, possibly since the 2018 blue wave, maybe even worse than that. Because poll after poll after poll, including a recent Fox News poll, shows that Republicans are on the wrong side on every single issue. According to a recent Fox News poll, 87% support background checks for guns. 81% want to enforce existing gun laws. 81% want the legal age to be 21 to buy any gun at all. 80% support banning assault weapons, but only 45% say that we should have more Americans carrying guns. So on the issue of gun control, on every piece of gun control, according to a Fox News poll, Republicans are on the wrong side. On the issue of abortion, 56% of people in the Fox News poll say that it should be legal, compared to 43% who say that it should not be legal. Now, that's just one Fox News poll. But if you look at all of the other polls as well, issues like attacking the transgender community and doctors and the parents of transgender children, an overwhelming majority of the public think that it's a problem that Republicans are attacking these people. Republican extremism, the Republican culture wars, have officially gone too far in the eyes and minds of the voters. And let me explain that for a little bit. Because we have seen Republicans for decades. Like, if you take away the last, you know, 3 years, and let's pretend that is the outlier, because it is the outlier. For the 40 years before that, Republicans were talking about, you know, making same-sex marriage illegal. George W. Bush ran on the concept of having a constitutional amendment to make same-sex marriage illegal. So basically, dehumanizing, degrading, and targeting the LGBTQ community. Republicans for decades have talked about banning abortion and overturning Roe versus Wade. They just, we could never quite do it. Even though they had the numbers multiple times over those 40 years to do exactly that. They've been talking about expanding access to guns, but they never actually did it. They never did any of the things that I'm talking about. Because they knew then how dangerous it would be for them to do these things. So they would run on them. They would say, give us the numbers and we can do these things. Then they'd get the numbers and just not do it. Like, they wouldn't address it. They wouldn't talk about it. Again, I know I've been in progressive media for 20 years. I've seen it happen cycle after cycle. But then the last 3 years, that's when everything changed. Instead of just talking about it and using it to bait their little voters along, they actually started doing it. And then they said, you know what? This just kind of feels good taking rights away from people. Let's do it more. Let's do it more. Let's do it more. And eventually those same voters that had been strung along for so long thinking it was going to happen, saw it happening and realized, oh God, this is horrible. Like, this is actually really, really bad. That's why we see red states pushing for gun control. We see Republican governors now pushing for gun control. We see red state voters overwhelmingly rejecting bans on abortion. Those voters have learned their lesson. The Republican Party has not. And they're doubling, tripling, quadrupling down on it, making it so much worse. And again, if these polls hold up, if the trends hold up, it is going to cost them dearly in 2024. And I'm talking massive losses for the Republican Party that we haven't seen probably in decades. And I hope that's what happens. This is Hattie. Hattie wants to know why you have not subscribed to our channel. You obviously like our videos, so do us a favor and subscribe.